126 English course. So they were both very, very great students who made some very awesome impressions on not only Professor So, but the rest of the students in the classroom. And Professor So has expressed that she is very proud of these two, and in their evolution and their writing, and especially in finding their voices, very, very powerful. So we'll start off with Jane, a little backstory. Jane Teodoro was born in the Manila, Philippines. She came to the United States at the age of 10. Wow. This is her first time taking a creative writing class, and she loves writing about her life experiences as well as her Filipino culture. Welcome, welcome, Jane. And next we have Dana. Awesome. Next we have Dana Eunice. So Dana Eunice discovered her love for writing at the age of 8. Wow, that is so amazing. An activist at heart, Dana worked as a journalist for 4 years overseas. Her passion for creative writing also led her to work as a copywriter for 7 years. She recently decided to acquire her bachelor's in journalism, woo, journalism major, yes, yes, and creative writing in honor of her late father. Thank you both for being here, and we did give them our undivided attention while they give us some spoken word pieces. Thank you so much.
Whatever I want to be, but abandoning my mind. Why is it such a touchy subject? career and life choices, especially with you, Mom. Why do I hear such disappointment in your voice when I say that nursing is probably not for me? Sorry that I'm not like my cousins that you always compare me to. Sorry that I want to explore things like painting, cooking, or doing makeup and hair. Sorry that your daughter, who you did not expect to have after having two miscarriages, is so good at so many things, which you failed to see. Time I drive my own car instead of being in the passenger seat.
2 years ago, I left my job as news producer at Al Jazeera and moved back to San Diego to care for my father, who passed away 4 months later. I had all these feelings filling my chest, ideas popping in my head like popcorn, poems cursive in my heart's veins, and they were all stuck inside of me, and I felt like I was going to explode. I needed guidance, form, structure. I was lost in insecurity, and my pen was too shy to write anything too personal. My voice didn't know how to own my soul's struggles until I decided to fulfill one of my forgotten dreams and arrived to Grossmont in tears, not sure if going back to school after all those years was a good idea. My counselor, Debbie, gave me privacy to cry, spent hours looking for, quote, classes that feed your soul, and took a creative writing class with Daniela, who encouraged me to express myself.
Anatomy class was my most rigorous class, which I couldn't even pass. I felt so discouraged about nursing, all this while dealing with a breakup. But despite of all my battles, my failure in my anatomy class led me to seeing a therapist in Cuyamaca College. Seeing a therapist has been the greatest thing I've ever done for myself. I am retaking my anatomy class next week, and this time I will not be weak. I will come into class with a new mindset. I will prioritize studying and realize that all my sacrifices will pay off in the end. And if it doesn't, then sorry, Mom, then maybe nursing is not for me.
Maybe the map of my life was not easy to read, not easy to follow. It took me through more dark and dingy roads that I wanted to wander through. Maybe the map of my life fed me more lessons than I wanted to swallow. But here I am. I brought me here today, and for that, I am grateful.